Welcome to all. Today we are going to study the MCQs based on the evolution topic. These are very important questions based on NCERT, very important for the forthcoming NEET and the AIIMS exam. First question is divergent evolution is. When we study the evolution topic, we study two types of the evolution. One is the divergent evolution and another is known as the convergent evolution. And in NCERT, various examples are given. Okay. So on page number 30, this question is from page number 30. That divergent evolution is homologous structure, analogous structure, eye of octopus and mammal, and flippers of penguins and the dolphins. So out of these, if you will see that divergent evolution is always associated with the homology, means the divergent evolution is related with the homologous structure. Okay, always remember, divergent evolution is associated with the homology, or we can say it as homologous structures. So question number first is having the answer A. Now question number two, examples of convergent evolution are. Now this was based on divergent evolution, now this is based on convergent evolution. Example of convergent evolution. This question is from page number 131. Okay. Evolution of examples of the convergent evolution are thorns and tendrils of bougainvillea and cucurbita. No. These are the examples of divergent evolution. Cheetah and whale forelimbs. Again, it is an example of divergent evolution. Sweet potato and potato and vertebrate heart or brains. So vertebrate heart or brains are again the example of the divergent evolution. But out of these, the examples of the convergent evolution is that NCERT, it is given that sweet potato and the potato are good examples of convergent evolution. So the question number two, the best option is question number two is having the answer C, that is sweet potato and potato. Next, phenomenon of industrial melanism demonstrates. On page number 131, the description about the industrial melanism is given. And always remember that the industrial melanism demonstrates what? So, industrial melanism demonstrates the natural selection. Always it demonstrates the natural selection. And this industrial melanism was seen in the England. Okay. And it is mentioned in NCERT. So, phenomenon of industrial melanism demonstrates natural selection. Question number 3 is having the answer C. Now, mutations discovered by Hugo de Vries are. Mutations discovered by Hugo de Vries are. On page number 135, it is clearly written that the mutations discovered by the Hugo de Vries are random and directionless. So, where it is small and directional, large and bidirectional, random and directionless, small and directionless. So always remember, the mutations which were discovered by Hugo de Vries were random and directionless. They were random and directionless. So question number fourth is having the option B. Now, single step large mutation leading to speciation is also called. Single step large mutation leading to speciation is also called as. So, on page number 135, this single step large mutation is called as saltation. Okay. So, single step large mutation leading to speciation is called as the saltation. Question number fifth must have the answer B. Question number sixth. Disturbance of Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium results in. Now, we know very well that Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium can be disturbed by at least 5 factors. Okay. And whenever, normally the Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium is constant. But the disturbance of the Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium results in evolution, variation, mutation or no gene. So, on page number 137 of class 12th NCERT, it is clearly written that disturbance of Hardy-Weinberg equilibrium results in evolution. So the question number 6 is having the answer evolution, that is A. So these questions were based on the evolution. Hope so you have liked this video. Thanks a lot.